So here's my project for today, another bracket, as you can see, just finished cutting. If you're wondering what these are, there and there, go and see my last video. I think you're going to like them, but I think you might like this even more. So let's go over to the glue table and get it glued up.
So here we are. So dry fit the parts. If you haven't done tabbing before, you're not very good, or you haven't set your kerf very well, I highly recommend getting some needle file. So if your tabs are a bit tight, you can just file them out to make them fit. It saves you throwing the part away. So I'm just going to use some standard wood glue and a cable tie to just get a bit of glue in there. Should be fine. Pop them in there. These are quite tight. Now you do want to make sure they're quite square, so look down there as best you can and get them square. I've got a little block here which is just perfect for this job. It's got a flat there, so I'm just going to put that on there and push that towards the block. It doesn't matter if it's not square, because I have a solution for that which will be coming up in the video towards the end. So once I fit this on the laser, all will become clear. So as long as this works out to be a good friction fit on the laser, so once we've glued this up, then the part is going to work fine, and there is a method to adjust this bracket to get it as best we can, which is going to be better than the two stupid screws that we're replacing. So we just run a cloth down there, get rid of the glue, especially on the inside, because that's where we don't want it. So just going to let that dry a little bit now. 10-15 minutes is going to be good enough, because it's not holding anything strong. But we can crack on with the other part of the video before I fit that. So put your lid back on. Clean your cable tight. And let's get back to the laser and get this thing fitted. So here we are then. So I'm going to take off my little levers, because it's just going to make it easier for the video. So if you haven't seen these levers, I think it's video 17. Now, if you've got the longer lasers, you're going to have to take out the two stupid little, I think they're 3mm screws at the back. Because if I loosen my, nuts off now, I've already removed mine, so I can move my laser. And those screws are to prevent that very problem. So I'm just going to put that up and lock those nuts on again. So whether you've got this mod or you've still got the thumb screws, it doesn't matter. Just as long as you've removed the two screws at the back. This, I think you can guess where it's going to go now. It's going to slip up behind the laser, and it's going to protrude past the back plate. So this is the back plate here, so it's going to grip on the back plate and protrude onto the plate that the laser's mounted on. So let me just push that on now. So the notches here and here are to make sure it misses the bolts, and this part here is to miss the third wheel, which is behind the laser.
I've redesigned the bracket, so I'm just going to dry fit this one-handed now. So when it's fitted, just need to drop that down a little bit. When it's fitted properly, i.e. it's pressed up against the plate, the bottom of the smooth slider is now level with the bottom of the metal bracket here, and that will give you the correct gap there. So I still recommend getting a pencil and marking in here. Let me just find a green pencil. So you're still going to mark in there and in there, so you know where not to put the glue. And I'm not going to be able to show you this. I'm only on my phone at the moment. I haven't got my camera set up. So when you go to actually fit it, I would dry fit it first. And this is how I'm going to ask you to dry fit it. So you're going to slide that up the back. He says, doing it one-handed. And make sure when, well, you can dry fit it, press it straight on the back plate like it would normally be fitted with the glue. So the sides are protruding the 3mm. But when you have the glue applied, if you, when you're slipping it up the back, if you pardon that expression, don't try and push the smooth slider bracket up against the metal, because the hot glue will dry too quickly. There is enough room now that if you look at that, the side parts of the smooth slider are actually level with the front of the back plate. So I've got a gap of around 3mm between the back of the back plate and the smooth slider bracket. So you can just about see that. Let's go back a bit and you'll be able to see it. So what I'm saying is dry fit it so it slips up the back and press it in to make sure you've got a nice fitting friction fit on the back plate. Put your pencil marks on, then take it off and get used to fitting it. And you've noticed I've got the bolts in, so pretend now we've got the hot glue on. When you slide it up the back, leave an air gap until you're looking here and here to make sure you've got the gap. Once you've got the gap, then squeeze the smooth slider onto the bracket and you'll find the hot glue will grab a lot better. But now you can feel the bottom of the bracket is flush with the bottom of the back plate, and that gives you the correct gap. It doesn't matter what this gap is. This is between 2 and 3 mil. As long as there's a gap, because when the slider, when the carriage is moving, you don't want this to hit your profile. So I'm going to apply my hot glue, try and do it live. So I'm going to put my hot glue on the bracket, avoiding the green, because there's no point, otherwise you'll get glue seeping out there. I'm going to put my glue on, slide it up. It doesn't matter if it's touching the top there. Drop it down a little bit. I've still got a gap between the back plate and there, and then I'm going to squeeze it in, and it'll work because I've got my bolts in, and that's aligning the bracket for. I'm going to just get some isopropyl alcohol or any alcohol you've got, and just clean the back of the bracket. It could have some form of oil film on that. Not much dirt coming off that, but you could have smoke and debris, thinking about it now, from lasering operations. That's quite clean, but it might just do the trick. And now my hot glue might be a bit hotter than it was a few minutes ago. So again, just going to practice myself, because you need to get this section slipped up behind the wheel. So that's still good. Practice again. So once that slips in behind the wheel, you then need to make sure the cutouts are above the bolts. If you're below the bolts are now sticking through the back by a good 5mm each side. So I'm going to slide it up without touching,
drop it down onto the bolts, and then I'm going to squeeze.
So you can see there the amount of hot glue. I've given it a good splodge because I'm not afraid of it oozing out, because I know it's easy to trim off. It's better to have too much, and because it's hot glue, it's going to ooze out. Just don't go too close to this cutout, because it will ooze up where the hot wheel, the third wheel is. You don't really want hot glue going onto that, but there is a good quantity of hot glue, and that's what I use to, and that's the amount I use when I was putting on my bracket, and it's on there really tight. So be generous with the hot glue. And this time I'm not worrying about it squeezing out. The redesign of the bracket just makes it easier to get it lined up. Just keeping the pressure on there. I can feel the warmth in the metal of the back laser back plate. The hot glue that's oozing out, you can always just trim that off afterwards, because those blobs here where my thumbs are going to affect the way the laser runs up and down on the back plate. And then these bits down here can just be trimmed off with a knife. So I'm just going to let that go hard. Unplug my glue gun. And see how well that's grabbed on. You can see the hot glue now changing colour as it's cooling down. Okay, that one's okay. But I think the left-hand side, I've got to get a bit of hot glue on the nut. Yeah, I have at the back, I can just feel it. But that's coming out all right. So I'll take that off. And then what I'll do, I will just trim the hot glue off the back where it's oozed around the thread. So we have a look around the back.
Where are we?
You can just see the glue's just appeared there, but that will easily come off. And there's a little bit this side as well. If you're doing it above your honeycomb bed like I am, make sure you clean your honeycomb bed off of any glue that you drop down, because that might catch fire. Yeah, that's fine now. A little bit stiffer than it was, but once those bolts are in, that's going to be fine. And I can, once I get round the back, I can just trim that off properly. On the top of the smooth slider, where these arches are now round, there's just a bit of hot glue caught in the top. You can see that attempt I had way too little hot glue on there. This was another prototype I was doing when I was just adjusting the height of the bracketry.
So the hot glue's gone off, so I'm just going to try and slice this off now.
So now I'm going to try and push this bracket off. So again, I've got my thumbs, so my fingers at the back of the profile, the gantry, and I'm just going to try and push with my thumbs to see how easy or how difficult it is to pop it off. Yeah, that's not going to come off. That's on there well and proper now. No, so I was being too stingy with the hot glue on my first couple of attempts. It wasn't working well. And even if the glue's come through here, actually, you know, this glue is gripping on the profile, on the back plate. Oh, that's solid. So I think if I was going to try and force this off now, I would actually take all the wheels off,
to take this back plate off and then try and get it off, because if I tried to force that off now, there is a chance that you're going to either bend this plate or bend your profile. So the trick is lots of hot glue, let it ooze out. You can always trim it back. So the first two attempts I made, I didn't put enough hot glue in, but that's all part of the R&D stage. For me to make the mistakes, me to break my laser, well, hopefully not. And then when you guys come to do it, you know exactly how to do it. So yeah, I'm well chuffed with that.
The laser slides up and down. There is a little bit of left to right motion, but I can get rid of that if we really want to. But that's no worse than what the screws gave you. Now, you're going to ask the question, Andy, why am I bothering to do this? Well, let's think ahead. Let's think if you're going to have to maintain your laser, you need to clean your smoke guard, and you need to take the laser off to clean the fan and everything. Well, it's easy now, isn't it? We've got none of those stupid screws at the back. So all we're going to do is undo the bolts or undo your thumb screws. Take the wire off. Now, when you remove the wire, make sure you've got your thumb now under the white plug and don't pull the wires, or you can secure the wire, but I'm not pulling on the wire. I'm pushing up on the plug with my nail. So let's get that out of the way. I'm going to undo the screws. And these are M5 20mm screws. So you see the video, I think it's number 17.